we can say in on time of this IGBT, when this is off, we are receiving positive voltage here. Return path from this IGBT to charge this capacitor. That means we need to charge this capacitor before turning on this stage. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. In my last video, I discussed bootstrap capacitor for high side IGBT switching. I explained in detail why we need bootstrap capacitor and what is bootstrap capacitor and how it works. But today we will see the same lecture with some different angle. I hope if you will watch this video, then there will be no confusion about function, about working of this bootstrap capacitor. When we see push-pull drive, any load transformer is supplied with positive voltage at center tip point. In push-pull configuration, we have two transistors which will switch one by one. These will switch ground potential to the transformer windings one end and second side ground potential to second side. To turn on, to operate this IGBT to MOSFET, we need gate to source voltage in case of MOSFET. We need gate to emitter voltage in sense of IGBT that are called VGS, voltage gate to source. A pulse is applied, but that pulse must be applied between emitter and gate or source and gate. When we come here in this configuration, we connect two IGBTs or two MOSFETs between positive rail and negative rail. One pair in this side, second pair in this side. It is called bridge technology. Full bridge, H bridge. Positive voltage will come from one IGBT, will pass to load, then to second IGBT ground. So it will switch in cross, or it will switch in this way. These two are these two. To power on these IGBTs, as we discussed here, we need voltage from gate to emitter or gate to source in case of MOSFET. For that purpose, high side and low side gate driver IC is used. IR2101, 2102, LF2101, different ICs that are called high side and low side driver. VCC, that are supply voltage. These VCC voltage are supplied here, then these are reaching to totem pole drive, VCC positive and low. This gate driver set will receive positive and common voltage, and it will provide pulse to low side IGBT. We can say for both side, low side IGBT driver IC will receive VCC voltage that are 15 to 18 volts, and this end is grounded and it is connected to common ground, same this side, and it is also connected to VCC. If you will apply any pulse here from microcontroller, this pulse is 5 volts to the control logic, and it will drive this side. This is low side, L in, and this is H in. When this pulse is present, it will provide LO signal. If it is high, high side driver transistor will turn on and it will switch. When this transistor will switch, it will provide this voltage here. It will drop 1.4 volt. So this point, will float 1.4 volt above than this ground level. This side 310 volt, 1.4 volt will drop here. Remaining 308.6 volt will reach here. These two points are floating now. This is floating then ground level to upside, and it is floating down then 310 volt. Two conditions. When this is on, this side is low. We have this transistor. If we want to turn it on, we need to provide a signal between gate to source pin, gate to emitter pin, same as we applied here. This is emitter or source pin. So ground common point that is connected here. The same 5 volt pulse with different time duration will reach here. That is with reference to this ground level, 5 volt, and it is also 5 volt. Now if we want to switch this stage, how it will switch? For that purpose, a bootstrap diode is connected here, then a current limit resistor, it is connected at this point. This positive side is now connected here. If this pulse is present, this high side transistor will switch. But we need to provide voltage level with respect to gate to emitter between these two points. If we will provide positive voltage, now if we see from this side, this transistor is turned off. When it is turned off, that means no ground potential is present here. We need positive voltage here with respect to source pin, emitter pin. If we connect here, that means this power supply cannot complete its path. So it will not allow to turn on this IGBT. When we turned on this side, it was low. When it was low, if we provide signal here, that time this IGBT will turn on. In that condition, what will happen? This IGBT is turned on, this IGBT is turned on. The first thing, positive voltage will switch to ground side. Both IGBT will blast. One condition. The second condition, when we will connect this end to ground, this section will be bypassed. To overcome this problem, when this transistor is off, we need ground potential with respect to this positive voltage. We need a capacitor here that is connected between these two points. It is called now VB, bootstrap voltage, and it is called C bootstrap. This is D bootstrap, R bootstrap. So these components, diode, resistor and capacitor, these are called bootstrap components. Positive voltage will reach here to this diode, resistor. It will reach to this capacitor positive terminal. When this transistor is off, positive voltage are here and ground side is reaching to this capacitor. When it is reaching to this capacitor, 1.4 volt will drop here. So floating 1.4 volt, then ground level, this capacitor will charge. If we provided 18 volt here, 18 minus 1.4 minus 0.7 might be 0.5 volt, 0.3 volt here. We can say 1 volt across these two components, 1.4, 18 minus 2.4 volts, approximately 15.6, 16 volt will appear at this capacitor. This capacitor will charge in on time of this IGBT. Now, if this IGBT is turned off, we have now standalone power supply which we charged at this capacitor. Positive voltage are already here and we have voltage source now here between bootstrap pin and this emitter pin. Now, if this transistor will turn on, these voltage, positive voltage will provide it to this gate pin. It will turn on. Positive from here, source pin to this point. It will complete its cycle. For discharging, this side, it will discharge. We can say in on time of this IGBT, when this is off, we are receiving positive voltage here. Return path from this IGBT to charge this capacitor. That means we need to charge this capacitor before turning on this stage. That means low side drive must turn on before turning on high side. It will turn on, it will provide charging voltage to this capacitor. Then this pulse will arrive here. It will switch, provide positive voltage for charging. So it will charge from positive source pin, capacitor negative terminal. So IGBT will receive same pulse with this voltage level. When this pulse will turn off, this transistor will off, this will on. At that time, ground side potential will connect it to this IGBT gate pin. So it will discharge. Same phenomena in this side. In some standalone ICs, we need external diode, resistor, capacitor, and a protection diode. But in IPM, we need external capacitor only. When the capacitor is calculated, gate capacitance, how much gate capacitance is there? What is the switching frequency? What is the duty cycle? These elements are kept in mind to bring a good capacitor value. In practical electronics, when this capacitor is failed, what will happen? Low side, for example, this side, we have this pulse. This is low side. The same pulse after that time will arrive at high side. If this capacitor is bad, during turn on time of this IGBT, this capacitor will not fully charge. In that condition, might be when the pulse is there for high side, it will not allow to charge this gate. Might be the drive will appear at this time only. The remaining time, the machine will turn off. The load will not receive power. That is the biggest problem in case of failure of this capacitor. Because in each cycle, high and low drive, in complete cycle, low side, this capacitor will charge. In high side, it will charge the gate, then it will discharge the gate. First, it will charge itself, it will obtain charge, then it will charge and discharge this gate. We have two different scenarios here. The first, positive voltage from here, return from here, it will charge. When it is charged, the pulse is shifted from low side to high side, then it will provide switching on pulse on this IGBT. When the pulse is removed, it will turn off this IGBT. So same configuration that is used here, exactly same here, as we see in this shape. This is high drive here, low drive here, common to ground. This source high side source pin to this common point. Same here, source common point, LO, low drive here, common to this point, high drive to this point. Here is high in and low in, two pulses with different time sequence that are controlled from the microcontroller or any push-pull driver IC. Here we need VCC. For this VCC voltage, we need diode, resistor. These are reaching at this VB pin. To maintain the voltage here, we need a capacitor here that is connected between source pin and VB pin. The same here, VCC. So this is the circuit and this is the working theory. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.